Two former Soviet republics are currently at odds. At one point, it was described by analysts as the worst bilateral relationship in all of Central Asia. The relationship in question is that between Uzbekistan and its southeastern neighbor, Tajikistan. Ever since the dissolution of the Soviet Union, the two sovereign states have been plagued by geopolitical tensions and mutual distrust. It's only in recent years that things have finally begun to simmer, thanks to factors like new leadership and new economic ties. But now, all of that looks to be in jeopardy. The reason? A multi-billion dollar, 335-meter dam scheduled for completion in 2029, located on the Vakhsh River in central Tajikistan. When finished, it'll be the tallest dam ever constructed. Yet, it's more than just a daunting task of engineering. It also poses vastly different implications for Tajikistan than for Uzbekistan, threatening to inflame old grievances and cause the recent and much-needed reconciliations to simply unravel. Join us as we take a closer look at the surprisingly deep history of this ongoing project and the frightening international consequences it could bring with it. Another thing that's going to have global consequences is a game-changing tool called InVideo AI. With its latest version, InVideo AI V3 enables you to express your ideas in the form of stunning videos, the kind you've always wanted to create, the kind you'd be excited to share within your peers, in the most seamless, intuitive way possible, irrespective of whatever skill level you're at. For example, you can ask it to create a 30-second to 1-minute video that captures the essence of humans of New York through realistic, close-up shots of men and women. Here's just a sample.
Each with a story etched in their eyes, from the wrinkles of experience.
You can also edit anything you like add my voice. Thanks to the integration of generative capabilities, InVideo AI V3 lets you create videos from scratch on any topic you can think of, whether it's dramatic stories, ads, educational content, and so on. Unlike traditional video tools with steep learning curves that only solve for parts of your video creation process, InVideo is the creative partner that you've always wanted that removes all friction and makes the process so intuitive and fluid that it disappears, letting users focus entirely on their vision and their idea. This is a real revolution for video creation, and the great thing is that by using the link in the description or pinned comment, you could try InVideo AI for free, but if you want to use their generative capabilities, I highly recommend that you go for the generative plan that starts at $96 a month. It's the one that I have and gives you the most bang for your buck with 15 generative minutes. If you're already an InVideo user, you can simply go to the add-on section and buy generative seconds. Believe it or not, the first time anybody suggested building a dam in the location now under construction was all the way back in 1959, 32 years before the end of the Soviet Union and 32 years before Tajikistan even existed as an independent nation. Soviet leadership saw a pressing need for industrial development in the mostly arid and remote region, thousands of miles away from the empire's capital in Moscow. It was decided that the best way to achieve this would be the creation of an enormous hydroelectric dam on the Vakhsh River. With this massive dam, electricity could be generated and irrigation could be improved, allowing sought-after agricultural and economic growth. However, the Soviet bureaucracy, not renowned for speed or efficiency, immediately saw they were up against a challenging task. The Vakhsh runs nearly 500 miles across a high-elevation swath of Asia, where, even today, it almost seems there are more mountains than people. Back in 1959, even getting there was a logistical challenge. The planning required to get a project like this off the ground proved almost insurmountable. Add to that competing priorities and demands for resources all over the Soviet landscape, and the project soon saw years going by without any real action taking place. Finally, in 1976, construction began, 17 years after the plan was first drawn up. However, 15 years after that, the whole Soviet Union dissolved, after having built only the most basic preliminary elements of the dam in that time. With the Second World disintegrated, everything was more or less put on hold. Tajikistan, now an independent nation, spent the better part of the 1990s fighting a ghastly civil war. Democratic reformists, former Soviet elites, and Islamic groups all vied for power in what eventually led to as many as 100,000 deaths, as well as 1.2 million people displaced and a crippled economy. The violence only ended after a UN-brokered peace agreement in 1997. Needless to say, the old Soviet plan for the world's largest dam was miles from anyone's mind at this point in the story. But a handful of years later, by the mid-2000s, interest in the project began sprouting up once again. As the world moved into the 21st century, Tajikistan remained plagued by severe energy shortages stemming from the war. As the years piled on, the stakes grew higher and higher. To fail to expand its energy infrastructure meant blackouts, rationing, economic stagnation, and social and political instability. But to revolutionize the energy sector meant the chance for unprecedented economic growth, independence, and geopolitical strength. Tajikistan could, in theory, become not only energy independent, but an energy exporter for surrounding countries like Afghanistan and Pakistan. This could transform the nation's stature on the world stage. In 2004, the long-forgotten megadam project was suddenly thrust back into the spotlight. Rusal, a Russian aluminum company worth almost $20 billion, agreed to take on finishing the project. Of course, this wasn't purely out of the goodness of their hearts. Key to the agreement was the fact that Rusal would also build a new aluminum plant in Tajikistan, powered by the energy the new dam would generate. Things were back in action, but they didn't get off the ground right away. In 2007, Tajikistani officials scrapped the deal. It wasn't immediately made clear why, but further investigation revealed the unresolved dispute had been mostly over one very simple thing: how high the dam would be. This put another wrench in the works until 2008. At that time, Tajikistan was the poorest of the ex-Soviet republics in Central Asia. But even still, the nation boldly announced it was resuming the dam project independently. Desperate for funding, Tajikistani officials went so far as to create a program for Tajikistani citizens to buy and sell shares of the dam. This went on, albeit slowly, for the next 8 years. Then, in 2016, the Rogun Dam finally got the big breakthrough it had been seeking for 40 years. In July of 2016, it was announced that the Italian industrial group Salini Impregilo had agreed to take on the project for the high price of $3.9 billion. Those who had been following the history of the project would probably have noted that earlier, Tajikistan had boasted of raising a total of $188 million through their shares program, rather less than Salini Impregilo's offer. But most were distracted from this detail by what came along with the announcement. More information, at last, about what this unprecedented dam would actually look like. The project would consist of four components. The most expensive component, worth nearly $2 billion alone, would be the barrier itself. A rockfill dam standing 335 meters, or 1,099 feet high. This meant, quite simply, that Rogun Dam would be the tallest dam ever built, surpassing China's Jinping I Dam and its 305 meters. With the completion of other components such as power generation capacity and energy transmission infrastructure, the Rogun Dam would also flat out double Tajikistan's energy production, taking the implications of the project to unprecedented heights. This forecast of their nation's future could only be seen as a ray of hope by Tajikistani officials and citizens, but not everyone saw it that way. In fact, just 2 years earlier, Uzbekistan and other bordering countries requested that the World Bank conduct an impact assessment of the Rogun Dam project. We'll come to the results of that assessment and the reaction of Uzbeki leaders in a moment. While their neighbors raised questions, Tajikistan carried on with the project, seeing a surge in progress unlike any in the dam's long history. By 2018, Tajikistan's president, Emomali Rahmon, ceremonially started the first turbine in the hydropower plant, one of six to be in place when the project's fully completed. Thousands were reportedly in attendance. 1 year later, in 2019, the second turbine was started. The Rogun Dam is currently scheduled for completion in 2029. In the spring of 2024, Rahmon met with the director of Salini Impregilo, now renamed WeBuild, to discuss progress. Things have slowed since 2019, mainly due to the pandemic and spiraling costs, but construction's still very much underway. We may be looking at a completed Rogun Dam within the next few years. Unless, that is, Uzbekistan has anything to say about it. As mentioned earlier, Uzbekistan led the charge to conduct an impact assessment of the dam roughly a decade ago. In 2014, the findings from two studies were released. Both failed to find anything that would force the project to stop, but they confirmed what Uzbekistan had feared all along. the dam would likely disrupt Uzbeki agriculture. There's one main reason for this, and it may seem obvious, but the wider implications are much more complex and significant, as we'll see. The Rogun Dam, like any dam, is poised to disrupt the flow of river water in Central Asia. After all, that is of course what dams do, but Uzbekistan relies heavily on the Amudarya River, which is a tributary of the Vakhsh. Consensus seems to be that the Rogun Dam is likely to reduce the flow of the Amudarya. Uzbekistan relies heavily on cotton and wheat, both of which need irrigation from the Amudarya to grow. From their perspective, Tajikistan is aiming to commandeer the water used to grow Uzbeki crops in order to double its own energy production, and it's easy to understand the Uzbeki displeasure at this prospect. Yet there are more reasons why Uzbekistan's concerned. Another is fish. In the 1970s, the lower Amudarya saw 7,000 to 8,000 tons of fish catches per year. By the turn of the century, that number had dropped to just 1,000 to 3,000. This has made what was once a thriving part of Uzbekistan's economy now relatively small. Of course, this is due to a variety of factors, none of which can be blamed on a dam that hasn't even been built yet. But the imposition of the world's largest dam upstream of an already waning fishing industry hasn't endeared Uzbekistan to the project any further. The concerns are also not strictly economic, they're also environmental. The region's already in the midst of the ongoing Aral Sea crisis. The crisis is named after what most experts now describe as a former saline lake in Central Asia, once the world's fourth largest. Today, the once great Aral Sea is little more than a few splotches of water dotting the map, with massive expanses of boat-littered desert in between. This alarming transformation is almost entirely attributed to rivers being diverted for irrigation. Once again, none of this is exclusively Tajikistan's doing, far from it. But given that Central Asia is already home to a world-famous disappearing sea, widely regarded by environmental scientists as a leading example of total ecosystem collapse, the enthusiastic creation of the largest dam of all time has raised some ecologically minded eyebrows as well. Another concern that has been raised is the fact that Central Asia as a whole is prone to those old friends of large dams: earthquakes, floods, and landslides. In theory, any dam can and should be built to resist natural hazards such as these, and there's no reason to doubt such risks are being factored into every step of planning and construction. However, detractors are right to point out that the Rogun Dam is different. It's a bigger dam than any built before, moving into uncharted architectural territory. Is pushing the envelope in a place where 2 million people a year are displaced by earthquakes such a good idea? Needless to say, the project is as controversial as it is awe-inspiring. For Tajikistan, the geographically smallest nation in Central Asia with a total population similar to that of a major city, the largest dam in history could be revolutionary. With energy production doubled, this resource-starved country could become a bigger player on the international stage than ever before. For Uzbekistan, the Rogun Dam represents something bordering on betrayal, a threat to economic security coming from an old enemy next door. Damming the waters of the Vakhsh is playing with fire, and if the completed dam makes a tangible impact on Uzbekistan's economy, the whole relationship between the two countries, so recently on the mend, could very well be history. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please be sure to subscribe for more content like this in the future. I'll see you next time on Looking For.